Okay, so we have started recording. Okay, well, welcome to our first video and stream class where we have our friends and then we have our friends. So welcome, welcome all. And today we are going to be working on a healthy spine. And if I were to tell you we're going to be working our core back, you may not have signed up for this. So, healthy spine today. Start just in our seated position, wherever you're at. Starting to just come back to our breath and really visualize what your spine looks like. Where there's little curves at the top of your neck. Way it makes a little S down your back. Tailbone. Picture it long and rooted, grounded, and healthy. Breathing in, filling your lungs, filling your belly. Exhaling, letting it all out, letting go, relaxing the shoulders. A couple more breaths here. Transitioning onto our back. Find ourselves in happy baby pose. May feel good. Cradle your knees in. Rock side to side. Up and down your spine. Before allowing the hands to reach inside the thighs. Grabbing for the outside of your ankles. Maybe the pinky toe edge of your foot. Driving the hamstrings, the top of the legs down towards the ground, the soles of the feet pointing up. And now checking in with your spine, starting with the back of your skull, neck. See if you can maintain this connection to the mat, not allowing the back up to the lower part of your spine to rock up to reach. Find it right, rounding, maybe coming back down slightly. And if happy baby is too intense, you can always take our bound angle or our butterfly on our back pose. Whatever feels good for you, just breathe into your body, into this space, into this place. Noticing what parts of your back compress a little bit more than others. You can curl your tail down slightly to increase that contact with the ground. Releasing your hands, keeping your legs where they are. Hands reach forward in between the legs. Inhale, exhale, we crunch up. Fingers drive forward. Exhale, back down. Inhale, exhale.
up, back down. Continue on your own, following your breath, really using those lower abdominal muscles to help bring you forward and up, back down. Go your own speed, key into your body, your engagement of these muscles, slow and control all the way up and all the way back down. One more, reaching out and holding up for three, for two, and one, all the way back down. Bring those knees towards your chest. Rock side to side, up and down. Cross the legs, cross the ankles, grab the back of the thighs, roll your way back up to a seated position. Just turn to face front of the mat, front of your eyes. We begin to inhale, raise our arms up towards the sky, twisting towards our right. Right arm reaches back behind us, left arm reaches for the right knee. Really find length in your spine, driving the chest up, driving the collarbones up, and then exhale. Inhale, you lengthen. Exhale, twist a little bit more. Gazing out over the right shoulder if that feels appropriate for your neck. Back to center. Inhale, both arms reach up. Exhale, left arm reaches back. Right arm reaches towards that left knee. Find length with your inhale. Exhale, twisting. Gaze out over the left shoulder. Inhale, arms reach back up. This time, exhale, right hand reaches towards the ground, walk the fingertips out, left arm reaches up and over. Really think about kicking out those left ribs rather than collapsing so much into the arm. Kick out the ribs. Reach those top fingers up, side. Breathing into that left side body. Inhale, both arms reach up towards the sky. Exhale, opposite side. Left hand reaches out. Walk the fingertips out. Right arm out and over. Kicking out those right ribs. Really stretching out that right side body. Inhale back up, both arms reach up, 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 and exhale, heart center. Take your right hand and put it by your right hip. Left hand reaches back behind to clasp your hand. If that isn't in your range of motion, simply allow the left hand. Fingertips to reach out towards the left side. We'll knock our right ear down towards our right shoulder. Really finding this stretch in our left side neck. Drive that right shoulder down. Drive the left shoulder down. That left shoulder, really feel that lengthening. Play around with the angle of your chin. See what feels good for you. Small motions. Maybe having the chin slightly up stretches this part of your neck that feels good. Maybe having it go down towards your chest, nose towards the armpit. Find that sweet spot for you and your body. Slowly release the clasp. If you have that bolster on your right side, head comes up, then left ear towards the left shoulder, switching sides. So left fist at the left hip, right arm reaches back, then clasping together. So left ear, left hip, right arm comes back behind. Then drive that right shoulder down and away to help lengthen the right side neck. Again, playing around with that angle. Chin maybe up, down, maybe neutral, in the middle. Really breathe into the sensation. More breath. Slowly rise. Head back to neutral. Release the fingers. And then bring them out in front of you as we come into tabletop pose. Warm up our wrists. Start to invite some circles forward, shifting the weight forward and back. Hips moving forward. Listen to the intuitive movement of your body, maybe adding in a couple rolls of the spine, switching directions. Back to neutral. This time, bring our fingertips and point them towards our knees. So wrists are pointing forward. This might be too intense. And if this is too intense, have it so the wrists face each other and the fingertips face the edges of the mat. Listen to your body, what feels right for you at this moment. Inhale, drop the belly, lift the chin, lift the tail. Exhale, rounding the back, really stretching into the arms, into the wrists, and inhale, opening cow, exhale, rounding into cat. One more like this, inhale, big exhale, rounding, stretching. Back to neutral. Bring the fingertips forward. This time take the right palm and press it down on the mat. So left hand stays in place. Right hand comes down. Fingertips facing towards that left thumb. Gentle pressure on that right wrist. Little circles. Directions if you have not already. And switching sides. So right palm on the mat, left back of the hand on the mat, fingers towards your right thumb. Again, little circles. Switching directions. Adding in a little bit more fun now. Go ahead and reach that right leg back behind us, having our hands back to our neutral position, fingertips spread wide. and then kick it out so it goes and crosses over our left leg. Gaze comes out over the left shoulder, open out through the right side body, gaze towards our extended legs, heel. Couple breaths here. And back to neutral, switching sides. Left leg extends out, cross it over the bent leg, then gaze out over that right shoulder. Towards the extended leg, really feeling that extension in the left side body. And return back to neutral. Right leg extends out again. This time, we have the option to raise the leg behind us. Toes pointing towards the ground, heel towards the sky, trying to keep in alignment with our spine, belly not allowing it to sink, drawing up towards the spine. Maybe even extending that left hand out in front of us, thumb towards the sky. Body has a tendency to let the belly slump when we extend out both the arm and the leg. So go ahead and cinch it up, drive it in. Breathe, hold for another five, for four, nice and strong, three, two, and one. Left hand comes down to the mat, left leg kicks out for supported side plank. So right leg reaches back, left leg kicks out, making a like 90 degree angle. Right arm reaches up towards the sky, wiggle those fingers, get that blood flowing back into the body. Stay here or option to take a full version of your side plank by allowing that left leg to stagger in front of leg. Driving the right hips up towards the sky. Gaze maybe out over those right fingertips. Then gaze returns back to the mat. Turn the hands to the mat and find yourself in plank pose. Nice strong plank, fingers gripping into the mat. Curling your back like we did almost in our cat pose. And then shift the weight forward, lower down in five, four, take knees at any time, three, two, and one, all the way down. Toes press into the mat. Inhale up, baby cobra, lift those hands off the mat, wiggle them out, that might feel good. Exhale back down. Do that two more times. Inhale, pressing the pelvis into the ground, pressing the tops of the feet. Nice baby cobra. Elbows dragging back down. Exhale. One more. Inhale. Chest raise up. Hands lift up. And back down. Press your way back up into tabletop pose. That's right, two sides. So left leg extends back behind us, then lifting it up, hanging out here for a while, or maybe allowing that right hand to come and reach out, fingertips driving forward, thumb driving up, heel driving up, toes driving down. Not allowing that belly want to collapse. Really driving up and in. Find that point of focus. Find that power you have in you. Hold. Hold for another three. Two. And one. Allow that right palm to return to the mat. Place the left leg down. Kick the right foot out. So it comes out to the side, making a 90 degree turn just about. And then coming into our side plank. Supported side plank. Left hand reaches up towards the sky. Again, always the option to step it up for the more intermediate yogis. Having that right leg come to the left. Driving the left legs up. Finding that straight line, finding your strength. Another three, two, one. First, the gaze comes back to the mat, then the left hand. Finding ourselves back in plank. This time, we'll take forearm plank. Fingertips reaching forward. Exhale, back down. Point the toes. Breaths here. Elbows are underneath shoulders. Gaze slightly down. Collarbones driving forward. Hips pressing into the mat. Belly still drawing up and in towards your spine, creating some space. Tuck toes. Inhale, forearm plank. Exhale, sphinx pose. Back down. Tuck toes. Inhale up. Exhale down. Three more. Inhale up. Exhale down. More inhale. Exhale down. Last one, you guys are doing great. Inhale up. Exhale down. Go ahead and have your hands return underneath your shoulders. Push yourself up and back to child's pose. Allowing the hips to sink into the heels. Arms reaching forward. You can be as passive as you want in this pose. Connecting to your breath. Remind yourself when you came to class today. What is it that you are hoping to gain by getting on the mat? Being kind to yourself through today's practice and through life. We are shaped by our experiences, both physically and mentally. We are right where we need to be. Go ahead, lift our way back up to your tabletop. Walk the hands forward, just a handprint. Tucking the back toes. That's right, downward facing dog. Hips right up towards the sky. Pedal the feet. Alternating heels. Really see if you can take the pressure off your wrist by allowing the weight to shift into the fingertips. Shifting into the fingertips, belly drawing up, tail drawing up. Then lift that right leg, three-legged dog, bending at the knee. Point your knee towards the sky, offering some circles with the knee. So painting, maybe a sun, your moon, maybe extending that leg fully and painting circles with your big toe. And stepping to the front of the mat in between thumbs. Allow that left knee to drop. Maybe widen your stance if you need a little bit more support as we enter into lunge. Arms reach up towards the sky. Keeping our knee from going beyond our ankle. Allow shoulders to drop down away from the ears. The left hand lands on the mat. Tuck the back toes if they're not already. Lift the knee up. Right arm reaches towards the sky for an easy twist. Easy is the name of the pose, not meant to necessarily tell you this is supposed to be easy. One more breath. And exhale, extended hand returns, framing that front foot, shifting the weight forward. We'll step to meet the right foot, hanging into a forward fold, keeping maybe a generous bend in the knees, shifting the weight forward into the ball of our feet. So it's not all heavy in the heels. Then maybe working our way towards extending and straightening through the legs. Inhale, flat back. Hands come to the shins. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, flat back. And this time, take the hands to the back of our skull. And like we're doing a crunch, big inhale here. Exhale, crunching forward. Really curling your chin towards your chest. Inhale up, flat back. Exhale, forward. Inhale up. Exhale, forward. Two more, inhale, and exhale. Last one, inhale up, exhale forward. Plant the hands, step the feet back into plank pose, lower down through chaturanga, upward dog, cobra. Then finding ourselves back in downward facing dog. Next side, left leg reaches up towards the sky, three-legged dog, bending at the knee, opening the hip, and then maybe inviting in some circles, maybe with our knee, or extending that leg if space permits. Flexibility permits to paint with the big toe. Then stepping forward, first your gaze comes in between the hands, then planting that left foot, allowing the right knee to drop, maybe widening your stance to help have a more stable base. As we enter into our low lunge on the left side, arms reaching up. Right hip drawing forward, hips are square, facing the front of the mat. And right hand comes down as we set up for our easy twist. Tucking the back toes, raising that extended legs. Knee, and then left arm reaches up towards the sky. Stacking wrist to over shoulder, shoulder over shoulder, and shoulder over wrist. Finding a nice line. Really finding the twist, drawing from our torso instead of our shoulder. Let the belly find you. Gaze back to the front of the mat. Left hand comes to the pinky toe side of the left foot, and then stepping into a forward fold. This time, depending on your flexibility, it might feel good to either have a hand on foot pose and massage the top of your wrists, pushing them between the ground and your feet. We're grabbing your big toes with your peace fingers, taking the elbows wide, or just reaching, finding that bend, letting the neck be heavy, nodding up and down, yes, side to side, no. And then deep in the knees. Allowing the glutes to come down towards the ground. And finding ourselves seated, our legs bent, or boat pose. So, shoulders down away from the ears, collarbones shining forward. Then we lift our right leg, keep it bent, lift it. Left leg keeping a bend. Maybe we could hold on to our thighs here. Maybe we just flirt with tapping the toes, alternating where they're at. Or maybe you can find some extension. Maybe you can release the thighs. And then lowering down to low bone, extend the legs, allow the back to curl, and then coming up, down, up, down, and down, and down, do two more. Then roll onto your back, hug those knees in, and then reach for your block. If you don't have block, that is fine. It's not required for this next pose. But if you have one, go ahead and give yourself a nice supported bridge. So take the block, put it underneath your sacrum. So that's all like the upper butt area, lower back. Knees should be about hip width apart, heels back towards your fingertips. And if you don't have a block, it might feel really good to just have your feet to the edge of the mat and the knees kicked in, resting on one another. Giving ourselves a little break from some of the intense core workouts we've done. Open. Big breaths here. As we enter this next move, I want to remind you that you are stronger than you think. This is a process. Go ahead and cradle your right hand towards you and send the left leg out. Again, this can be done on a block or not. Then bring your hands away from your knee and grab the block beneath you. So I'm grabbing the edges. Then bring that right leg forward so it makes about a 90 degree angle. And then switch legs. So just driving one knee up, bending the opposite, really keeping this motion really in front of us. This should be a pretty intense workout for the core, the lower core specifically. So it may help close your eyes and visualize that you're someplace else. Maybe you're snowshoeing. There's some fresh, wintry snow, soft and delicate, snow-covered trees, maybe even a cardinal in the distance, or a little white hare, watching the bunny hop to and fro. It's just you out there. Or maybe you don't like the cold. In the snow, and you're at the beach, and you walk into the water. You're treading through the water. You look down, you see the fishies swimming. Maybe a sea turtle comes up to say hello. And then coming back. Give yourself a break. Release the block. And hug those knees in. Rock side to side. Front to back. Take this moment to really feel the compression, legs on your body. How that impacts your spine, the connections that you feel with the ground right now, back of the skull, shoulders, upper back, mid back, low back. Then rock your way up to an extended leg forward fold. The toes reach up towards the sky and palms up towards the sky as well, maybe right next to your knees. Allow the neck to be heavy, the chin, the palm curl towards the chest. Depending on the flexibility, maybe the block can provide you some support for your head. Check in to where you feel sensation the most without criticism. But just awareness, healthy curiosity, you and your body. Roll up. Cross your right leg, the left. Left arm comes to give the bent leg a hug. Right arm reaches back. Nice long spine. Maybe bringing the back of the left tricep to the top of the thigh. Intensifies the pose a little bit more. Forward, switching across. Left leg over the right. Straighten up the spine. And left arm reaches back, right arm gives a little hug. Maybe pressing the back. Your right tricep into the top of that left thigh. Down, rolling on to our back one more time. Send the left leg out, right leg reaches up towards the sky, fingertips clasping maybe around the hamstring, maybe calf, maybe reach the toes. Do what you can do. Try to keep your back flat on the ground rather than curled up. Now, sinking the back. Then allow the right arm to come out towards your side, fingertips in line with the shoulder. Left arm is going to reach out about 45 degree angle. Yes, we're not done with the abs yet. And we'll big inhale, exhale, we crunch up. Reaching outside the leg and back down. And up, just 5, 2, 3, reaching across, 4, 5, come back down, bend that extended knee and allow it to drop over towards our left side. Big twist. If you have it in you to extend, move that top leg forward straight. Feel free to do that. But wherever you're at, try to keep your right shoulder from wanting to lift up off the mat. That down. This helps keep the twist stemming from our spine. Healthy spine. Legs extended, go ahead and bend it. Going back onto your butt, curl it in. Give it a nice hug. And extend the right leg out to the left. Tag team, left leg extends up towards the sky. Hip fingertips walk up the leg to the point. Go before your shoulders start to reach up. Shoulders start to reach up, back off. Keep them connected to the earth. Several breaths here. Big hamstring stretch. Really feeling lengthening the back of our leg. Trying to find that space. You're not resisting. Allowing yourself to surrender. Having the bent knee is just fine. Then getting into our obliques, left hand reaches out to your side, help create a stable base, right arm cups to the outside of that extended leg, put up towards the sky, and five crunches here, we can inhale, exhale, reach it out as far as you can, and back down. Exhale, reach. Inhale back. Exhale, reach. Inhale back. Two more. Exhale. Back down. Last one. Reach, 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 reach. And back down. Bend that extended leg and cross it over the right. Big twist. And finding the space, still steady your breath. Backing off if you find it. Struggling, quickening. Always the opportunity, it's in your practice to extend that leg. Maintaining that left shoulder connection to the earth. Remind yourself that movement is medicine. Stay moving. It's part of our preventative practice. Move your body, move your breath. Travel through in and through out. Legs extend and allow it to come back to bend. Roll onto your back. Drive the knees in towards the chest. One more happy baby pose. Like when we started today's class. The pinky toe edge of the foot. Maybe the ankle and the shin. Driving. Tailbone down, pressing it into the ground. Try to bring those knees down towards the ground. Flexed, facing the sky, ceiling, out and beyond. Bring the soles together, allow the feet to come back to the mat. Extend them out for our final Shavasana. To help support a lower back, oftentimes a blanket pulled up or pillow might feel really yummy underneath. Perhaps some weight on the hips. Some even like a block under the back. Open up the heart. Grab a blanket if you need. Take this time to check in with your body. Do your own little scan. Try to listen. What is calling to you? What part needs attention right now? Send your breath where it needs to. Shoulders and arms. The back seat to the earth. The hips, legs, toes follow. Allow your breath to cascade through your body. Flooding it with oxygen. Movement. Allow yourself to picture the space here. Where are the walls? What's around you? See your body in that space. Calm, relax. At ease. Come back to that body. Toes, fingers, allow the corners of the lips to curl up for a smile. Then roll onto one side. cradling your arm. Your head is in the middle of your arm. Place of comfort, ease. Perhaps use this opportunity to send a message out to somebody you care about, love. With a tap on the ground, seal that message. Slowly push your way back up to a seated position. Feel your root connected to the earth, your spine long. Understand you did that. You cultivated the space. Fine. I'd like to thank each and every one of you for joining me on today's practice. I hope there is a sense of calm you cultivated today that carries with you. I can see you again. Namaste.